when she saw how evil these people are and how non-respectful of any laws they act with their own laws. So
they tried to shut you up, basically, correct?
Yeah, they tried to shut me up for good. They tried to arrest me. They tried. They shut down my website. They also threatened me, saying, "If you don't shut your website, we're gonna take your children from you." You know. And yeah. This is, I think, a threat that no father wants to ever listen. And unfortunately, these people are criminals. And but I have hope, Greg, that the movement is growing around us, a positive movement of people, of true believers, that will come more and more together. And you will see that, yes, the enemy is manifesting more and more his evil, but also goodness will have to manifest more and more to front this great evil. And I think that good people will come together to the realization that we have to fight this enemy in Rome and in the Zionists in Jerusalem, because they are the enemy of mankind.
Yeah,
and we have to find a solution.
Well, listen, you know what? I'm going to give out the phone number again, and I will get to DM in California right after this break. But if you want to call us in the last half hour, 800-313-9443, 800-313-9443. Back in 3 minutes. I was back on the Investigative Journal, and I just wanted to remind our listeners, we do not screen calls on this show. We do not cut you off if you call and you disagree with what we're talking about. All points of view are listened to and respected, and if you want to get your voice heard, no matter if you agree or disagree, make sure you call me at 800-313-9443. That's 800-313-9443. And now let's go to California. DM, you're on the Investigative Journal. How are you?
About yourself, Greg.
Good. I'm doing good. Do you have a question for my guest or a comment?
Indeed. It's good to hear Leo. I was actually checked him out on a couple of other shows that you got him on, so it's good to have the opportunity to be able to talk with him and share some information.
Hello.
Or ask a question. Hey.
Nice meeting you.
Likewise. So in the spirit of truth, I mean, because, you know, we're talking about some pretty heavy-duty things here. I mean, yeah. You know, we're talking about, the New World Order. From a religion, it's definitely involved because we're already talking about people being chipped, which goes along with the mark and the mark of the beast and things of that nature.
Yes.
And then, so we've seen, we've seen basically throughout history lots of organized deception through the various religions and the different people who are sitting in certain positions of, rulership or whatnot, how they've been deceiving people. So I was kind of curious, Leo, what would you say to the scholar who has found that that Jesus was known to be, was what many would know today as being a black man? Where your degrees and knowledge and research, have you run across that information?
I have no problem in the fact that Jesus might be quite a black complex due to the nature of the place he was coming from. I mean,
right.
I don't have absolute any. I don't see Jesus as an Aryan blonde. I'm not Himmler or Hitler, thanks God. And
right.
I hope that the Vatican will also shed some light on this someday, because all these images of Jesus, all blonde and Aryan, are quite contrary to the reality of facts.
Right.
So I can tell you that Palestinians, the two Palestinians, I know, at least my friends, they are very dark and complex, and we can maybe describe them as being with Negroid features, so black, yes.
Right.
I don't have any problem with that, absolutely not.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting, because that would seem to be a major, like, pretty serious in terms of, like, on one level, people say, okay, yeah, it doesn't matter because, God is for, all the people, which I agree with that on the philosophical level and all the levels of which that really means. But the only reason why I would bring it up is because that's a major factor in terms of the psychology of the people, how it's been cultivated.
Well, I can also say that in ancient Rome, for example, people from the blonde regions were considered the inferior species to the Romans and to the dark people. The people from the north of Europe were quite treated badly in ancient Rome as an inferior race because they didn't have dark features. So
right.
it's,
And I just want to say really quick, I think that we need to learn from that, from people mistreating each other, you know, whatever the race
absolutely.
Is, or to try to
absolutely.
Teach, you know.
And I see that the black Afro-American has a lot to do with what is happening at the moment, because they have unfortunately supported with the Prince Hall Freemasonry a lot of the creation of contemporary lodges throughout the United States connected to this evil chain, which goes back now 300 years, but is connected to the Vatican. So even the Prince Hall lodges now that have a complete recognition from other lodges are considered finally, even by Freemasons, their equals. We have to remember that up until 10 years ago, not 100 years ago, but 10 years ago, Freemasons, black Freemasons couldn't meet with white Freemasons.
Right.
Because the Prince Hall Freemasonry was only for blacks and no whites were allowed, and no blacks were allowed from Prince Hall lodges in normal lodges. So
right.
this was completely racist, and obviously didn't happen all over the world. In France, we always have a normal kind of Freemasonry with black and white people. But in America specifically, Freemasonry was actually a very racist thing. And only now we are finally seeing the openness towards Prince Hall lodges and the recognition of the fact that they are also brothers. Unfortunately, I see also that Prince Hall lodges are being abused, and actually we have an example of that. If you go on the site of the Regular Grand Lodge of Virginia, which we have talked about with Greg in one of the episodes, previous episodes of the Investigative Journal, you can see that there is the grand officers are two black Freemasons from the Prince Hall Freemasonry who are working with Klaus Schmidt, a notorious Nazi, mm-hmm. and with Pasquale Cerofolini from the P2 network. So you are basically, because they need the black people in the society for the selling of the drugs
right.
and weapons. And this is a link that unfortunately we have to understand. A lot of lodges nowadays for black Afro-Americans are used for weapons and drugs. This
yes,
is a reality. It's a sad reality, and it goes down to the gangs. Even the gangs in New York or in L.A., they are ruled by Masonic lodges.
Right.
So this is something, and these Masonic lodges are ruled by the Vatican. So
right.
you are basically under the control of the evil eye at all time, and the evil eye is the eye of organized religion that has nothing to do with Jesus.
Okay, Leo, we're going to take a break right now. DM, thanks a lot. Call back again. We're going to be back in 3 minutes. 800-313-9443, and I'll get to all your calls right after this break. Strange is happening here. With information like this, Leo, Americans are starting to wake up. Let me get right to the phone lines. In Louisiana, Kerry, you're on the Investigative Journal.
Hey,
any question or comment?
Yes, sir, Greg. How you doing?
Good.
Yes, the question I have for your guest, I heard something.
Go ahead.
Break it up there. Now, the question I have for your guest, and I apologize, I try and say his name, but I know I'd butcher it.
Leo. Just call him Leo.
Leo. Okay. Leo, have you heard anything about the Illuminati murals at the Denver International Airport and the underground base that's there? Any validity to any of that?
Well, I haven't personally had only superficial things. I couldn't give you any inside information that is not readily out there. I just had a look at it. And obviously I can say that Illuminati have underground bases all over the planet, like the one that I talked about in London called Pindar. But many other are, like, for example, here in Oslo, where I reside, there is a base for 2,000 people. And obviously when the time will happen that they have to close down the cities, this will be the only security areas that are guaranteed within the city. So they are trying to prepare them and to get people to use them regularly, so they are very well equipped and trained, the people there. And when the time comes, basically we can say that apart from a military establishment and a few of the elite that will try to save also their asses, as we say,
right.
There will be not the possibility for the normal person to escape. So apart from going out of the cities will be off limits.
Right. So, okay. So what kind of time frame, what kind of timeline do you think we're looking at there?
We're looking from 2010. The situation will deteriorate. Let's say 2010. They will finally implement in the next 3 years the last there are road to martial law, to complete martial law.
So it'll take
then, when they have in control of everything, the problem is that still they can't control the wrath of nature, and nature will provoke some big catastrophes. And big